What we're going to do is we're going to merge these layers in the image. I'm going to merge one picture of this shot with a infrared, with a full spectrum camera with an infrared filter. That's why the pink, the trees are all pink and stuff. So we're just going to make some quick edits like this. Just a real quick edits. There we go. And we're going to do a little bit of vibrance here. So this is an edited full spectrum image. And we're going to export this. File exports. Just like that. I'm going to do this full size. Now, here's another picture I took with the full spectrum camera. But the difference is that I used a special filter. It's called a hot mirror filter. It lets me take regular pictures with that camera. So let's just do something like this. These are really quick edits just to get the point across. And since we're going for the anime look, I'm going to give a little bit of color cast. Just like that. Okay. And a little bit of luminance. Right, so we're going to open this in Photoshop. So edit in Photoshop. Should open up over here. So we have one image here, and we're going to superimpose it by placing another image. Place embedded. And we have our image from earlier. And we just want to put this on there. Now, even though I shot this image on a tripod, infrared light bends at a different, I want to say like a different angle. So even if I didn't move the tripod, there's still a little bit of movement, but that's not really my fault. That's just the way infrared light is. No matter how careful you try to be, infrared light just bends differently. So we're going to, first of all, select both of them. And the option you want is under edits. It's actually called auto align layers. However, if you see this problem that for some reason your auto align layers is grayed out, all you gotta do is come over here, right click, and rasterize layers. So once you do that, then you can go back here to image and auto align layers. Should be available. So just click auto. Let Photoshop do its thing. And your images should be aligned, just like that. Now, to finish off this image the way I was initially intending, I'm going to create a little adjustment layer, just like that. Get my brush and paint in the changes that I intended, just like this. So if I had more time, I would put more effort into this. This is just to show you how to auto-align some layers in Photoshop, just like that. And we're gonna change this building a little bit. And these buildings too. So we're basically just, actually maybe I liked it the other way. Just like that. We're just kind of blending some full spectrum images with a regular visible light image. So when you're done, you can just save it. And that's basically all you have to do. This is just an example. Like, this is not perfect. Like, I would crop this. I would have edited this image much better. And this is just for demonstration purposes, how to auto-align some layers in Photoshop. And this is very useful if you're doing some landscape photography or multiple exposures. You bumped into a tripod by accident. It's not difficult. Anyways, just showing you this little technique. hopefully you learned a thing or two, and I'll see you around.